go to Sinanis, I'll probably three from main primary school. So over here we have another question, and this question is about the methods of the limit calculations. Okay. Over these few lessons, we keep learning the definite integral, but actually our main focus is still not the definite integral. Our main focus is still the method of limit calculation. Just that, instead the methods of limit calculations, if you had noticed that there's a lot of methods. Some could be special, some could be general. So for all these methods, why so special is one, there's actually a lot of methods, and one out of these, a lot of methods are the, okay, we already learned before a few of them, and this is another one, which is the conversion between the limit calculation and the definite integral calculation. Okay, there's only one method for the method of limit calculations. So actually at last, the integrals also involved in the limit. Okay, so for here we are not mainly focusing on this question, but although this question, what is so special about it, is for us to learn how to construct, how to make a question, how to have a form, how to form a question. Actually, you change a little bit, it's another question. So this is actually having infinity questions. It depends on your understanding, because that if you don't understand, want to change, don't know. Okay, so here, now let me first write down the question. Okay, the question, which is limit n approaches to infinity and then sigma k equals from 0 to, I mean from 1. And then if you know, if you don't know, actually 0, if you want 0, it's to n minus 1. Okay, it's still the same answer. So here, this is n over n squared plus c. Okay, so it's n squared plus k squared x squared. Okay, so what if it was, okay, x, what cannot be equals to? Okay, if it equals to 0, let me just tell you, it cannot be equals to 0, as if it's equals to 0, would you notice what will happen to it? Okay, if it equals to 0, it will become, okay, since every time when k changes, here become one more time, then become this 1 over n, which is this part. Since there's the sigma, so need to keep on adding itself, and LI become n times 1 over n. N over n simplify, become 1. If not, it will be easy, it will become 1. Okay? So let's see, if it's like that, is it a determinable form or is it an indeterminable form? Okay? So let's see. Here is subbing infinity over infinity, not a determinable form, even inside the sigma. Okay? So here, I'll solve this question, although it will be very easy, but our main focus is not here. Our main focus is to construct the question. So now, let me just tell you one thing. Okay, so last few lessons we kept drawing in the graph, right? Let me just tell you that the general formula, let me write it down. The general formula for the this limit, okay? It's limit. Okay, this is how to show how to construct a question. So like this, right? But here we usually won't write table. But if here's came, we'll still write it. Okay? So this is actually the general form. So then just explain something about the left arrow and the right arrow. It just depends on the left and right. Okay? So now let's just continue. So this, which will become easy since you already changed it to sigma, but there's one problem. Although it's changed to sigma, it seems like you can straight away left. But please don't be so fast. There's still a few problems that you need to know. So here, this part which would denominator over n squared then plus k squared x squared, then this part, let's see. Here you need to handle 1 over n. Okay? Then after that, become limit n approaches to infinity . Okay, so here is still the same, then here become 1, then this part, let's see, it becomes k squared over n squared, which can be k over n bracket squared. And then this part need a UK. Okay, UK. And then this part, the delta U will equals to UK plus 1 minus UK, which will equals to 1 over N. Okay, so the UK will have the range of 0 to 1, okay? So after that, it will change into the integral, the definite integral.
So here now, Doma.
That's UK, we don't write UK, we just write UX. Okay. Because then here X, but then there's a square. And then here also have a square. The U. But we want it to correspond because then later I will show you something. So here, since here we times the X, so here we need to divide the X. Okay? Then have you noticed something special? We have learned before. Okay. It's a basic formula. Okay. So let me write it down. Which one is it? It's the 1 plus x squared dx. So this is for the tangent. Okay. And then this, which is the tangent inverse x, like this. So same thing. No. It's not anything about what you have thought of. Okay. Although when at last you get this, but please don't use the special limit one as there's no limits. Okay? So now to get it, actually this is quite simple. You can make a lot of questions yourself by using this. Okay? This is, but this is not that specific. What I really wanted here is not just XK. It needs to be K. It must be a function of this, so that we can let, and this will be so. And here we need to be 1 over n, okay? Like this. So actually, but this answer will still be like this. But most possibly, this a to b will be 0 to 1. Okay? So we can just change it. Like this. So actually, straight away, if you have followed this, you get the answer. So now, do you get it? So next time, if you make all these questions, you can straight away change it to like this, and then got the answer. So now, did you get it? So we'll end here, and next time we'll continue. So if you like our video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Tune in for more, and before we end, let me just explain that here you definitely need this formula and all these. Then follow this formula. So next time we'll see you, and thank you for your watching.